Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Drupal in your local host. And then I'm also going to show you how you can use Drupal for absolutely free in your local environment. So let's begin. Now to install Drupal, you need to first install Xampp so that we can create a local host environment in our local system. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in here, just simply type Xampp download. Then enter, and then you'll be seeing this www.apachefriends.org is basically your first search result. So now just simply click on download Xampp, and this will, you know, going to redirect you to this official site of Xampp. And here, if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be seeing these three options. So the first one is 7.3.29 PHP version. So if you are using some older version of PHP, you can just, you know, simply proceed with these links. But I am going to, you know, simply use the latest version of PHP, that is PHP version 8.0.8. To download Xampp for this latest version, you need to just, you know, simply click on download 64-bit. And this will, you know, going to open a new tab, and you will see your downloaded has been, you know, rightly started. Since I have already downloaded Xampp, just, you know, simply cancel it. And if you just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this Xampp has been, you know, rightly downloaded over here. And the file size is 160 MB. To install, just, you know, simply double click on it. And then you need to just simply click on yes to provide administrative privileges. And then let us first minimize our download directory. And we'll be seeing our Xampp setup wizard has been, you know, rightly opened. So just, you know, simply click on next. So these are the files that, you know, going to be installed. So just, you know, simply keep this all default, then simply click on next. And this is going to be your folder. So keep this all default, then simply click on next. And the default language is English. If you want to change it to Dutch, you can always do that. But I'm going to, you know, simply select English and then simply click on next. And now it's ready to be installed. So just, you know, simply click on next. And this will, you know, going to open your browser telling that say hello to your favorite application Xampp. So just, you know, simply minimize it, and it's now ready to be installed. So just simply click on next. And this will, you know, going to start installing our Xampp. It will take, you know, some time, maybe, you know, 4 to 5 minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after completion of this entire process. Yeah. And now it's asking to give allow access so that this Windows Defender does not block any features of this app. This is totally safe. You can just, you know, simply click on allow access. And now, as you can see, it's now currently completing the Xampp setup wizard. So just, you know, simply click on finish. And now, as you can see, our Xampp has been, you know, rightly installed, and our Xampp control panel has also been opened. In here, you need to just simply click on the start button so that our Apache gets started. And similarly, you need to also click on start so that our MySQL gets started. And you can clearly see our Apache and MySQL has been, you know, rightly started. And now you need to just, you know, simply click on this admin button of MySQL so that this PHP MyAdmin gets open. In here, you need to just simply click on new. And then you need to just, you know, simply give a database name. So we are going to, you know, install Drupal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, you know, simply give the database name as Drupal. And then just, you know, simply click on create. And this will, you know, going to create our database name called Drupal. And now all you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply download Drupal. So for that, just open a new tab, and in here just simply type Drupal download. Then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.drupal.org is basically our first search result. So now just simply click on download Drupal. And this will, you know, automatically going to redirect you to this official site of Drupal. And here, if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be getting this button, download Drupal zip. So, you know, just simply click on download Drupal zip. And this will, you know, going to start downloading our Drupal. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this Drupal 9.2.2 has been, you know, rightly downloaded over here. Now in here, all you need to do is, you know, to just, you know, simply right click on it, and then just, you know, simply click on extract all. And now just simply click on extract. So that this Drupal 9.2.2 has been directly get extracted over here. And now as you can see, our Drupal has been directly started extracting. It will take some time to extract. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after completion of this process. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can see, our Drupal 3.9.2 has been directly extracted over here. So just simply cancel this, and this is basically the folder which has been created. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply go inside that folder called Drupal. So if we again go inside that folder, here we'll be seeing all files. Now of what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply rename it to a shorter name called Drupal, right? And then if you just simply right click on it and cut, and then just simply go to your C directory, then Xampp, then local docs, and then if you just right click on it and paste, you'll be seeing this Drupal has been rightly pasted over here. Now all you need to do is simply open your new tab, and in here just simply type localhost/Drupal, then enter. So this Drupal is basically the name of this folder, Drupal, right? And then you'll be seeing this Drupal has been rightly opened over here. So this is basically the interface of Drupal 9.2.2. In here you can choose your language. I'm going to simply choose English, and then just simply click on save and continue. And now it's telling that what type of installation profile we want. I'm going to simply select the standard operation, and then just simply click on save and continue. And now it's telling that we have some requirements problem. So here you can see we have this PHP extension disabled. So just simply copy this GD, then right click on it and copy. And then all you need to do is you need to just simply open this Xampp control panel. In here, if you just simply click on this under this Apache, just simply click on config, then you need to just simply click on php.ini. So you just simply click on that. And this will going to open this notepad file. In here, you need to just simply press Ctrl F on your keyboard so that you get this find pop-up. Here, just simply paste your GD. Then click on find next, and you'll be getting this extension equal to GD. Here, what you need to do is you need to just simply delete this semicolon. Yeah. So just simply delete this semicolon, then just simply cancel this, and then just simply go to file, then save. And now if you just again go back to your page, you'll be seeing another warning is also showing. So for that, what you need to do is you need to just simply copy this OP code, just copy it, and then again go back to your our Xampp. Basically you need to go back to our this PHP file, and then again simply click on Ctrl F, and then just paste it, this OP code, and then just simply click on find next, and you'll be seeing this enable or disable OP code caching in our shared memory. So here what you need to do is you need to just first simply cancel it, and then just simply hit enter, and in here you need to paste some code snippet. I am going to provide you this code snippet right at our description. So all you need to do is you need to just simply copy this code snippet, and just simply go to our this PHP file, and just simply right click on it and paste. So you need to just simply paste this code snippet from our description, and then just simply first go to file and save. So just save that, and then just simply cancel it, and then all you need to do is you need to just simply first stop our Apache, and similarly you need to also stop our MySQL. So just simply stop that, and again simply click on start and start. So we are basically restarting our Xampp control panel by just simply stopping it and starting again. So we have rightly restarted our Xampp control panel. Just simply minimize it. And now if you just simply refresh our browser, you'll be seeing all errors and warnings has been indirectly gone. Right. So now, remember, we have created a database called Drupal. Right. So here, under this database name, you need to just simply provide that database name. So let's give the database name as a Drupal. So the same database name, that is what you need to give over here. And then you need to provide a username. So let's give the username as a root. And for the password, you need to just simply keep it blank. And then just simply click on save and continue. And then you'll be seeing installing Drupal. So it has, you know, rightly started installing our Drupal in our local environment. So after that, you can use Drupal locally in our system. So I'm going to also show you that. But for the time being, since it is installing, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to, you know, coming back after completion of this installation process. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can see, our Drupal website has been rightly installed. So here, all you need to do is you need to just simply provide a site name. So let's give the site name as Geeky Script. You should give your, you know, site name, and you need to provide an email address as well. So I'm going to, you know, provide my email address. You need to, you know, simply provide your email address. And now if you just scroll down a bit, you need to, you know, simply provide this site account maintenance. So here you need to just, you know, simply provide a username. I'm going to, you know, simply provide the username as admin, and the password is also, I'm going to, you know, give admin. Since I'm going to only use this machine, so I'm, you know, going to give an easy password. And then if you just want to check for regular updates automatically, you can check this. And if you want to receive email notification, you can also check this. And then just, you know, simply click on save and continue. And then after some time, you'll be seeing our website Geeky Script has been, you know, rightly opened over here. So this is basically, you know, the interface of our Drupal, and our website Geeky Script has also been created. So you can always simply click on edit button to, you know, edit anything from this site. So in this way, install Drupal in your local system. I have rightly shown you how to install Xampp to make our local environment, and in that we have, you know, rightly installed Drupal. So that's basically all of this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.